Welcome to Prefabricated Structures. In today's video, we will be looking for the design of cross-section based on efficiency of the materials. In this part, we need to see that the prefabricates are classified as homogeneous and composite based on the number of different materials used in prefabrication. Homogeneous prefabrication, the prefabricates which have only one material are called homogeneous. Means when we take a single material type of a particular panel or a particular type of thing, that time we can say it is a homogeneous prefabrication. The homogeneous may be hollow, they may be solid, they may be ribbed one. So it depends upon how the condition is there. So if solid it is, if the units which have a plane and a ordinary solid cross section which form a total mass of a structure are called as a solid cross sections. Means only one particular material is used. In one particular material that can be easily used for the particular part of prefabrication. Then comes a hollow. The hollow prefabricates which have a hollow openings or cores in it are called a hollow prefabricates. This openings are used ventilation for taking any line which may be electric line, water line, or any piping connections can be easily made from this particular hollow connections. Usually the hollow connections serve as the electrical conduit. Wherever the electrical connections are required, at that moment the particular part of electrical conditions can be easily taken for the sections. Then coming to compound wall panels. So these are the panels made up of many panels called as a composite panels. So when they are combined together, the similar type of different panels, they are combined together, that time we can say easily this is also called as a semi prefabricated, which are joined together during the erection. So the semi prefabricators are joined together during the erection. Those panels are a product in industry. The production process is mechanized and very easier than the sandwich panel. So we have seen some sandwich panels earlier. So in that way, this is one more called as a composite panels. And further, the compound wall panels may have two identical waffle sections produced by vibro rolling. So they are having a different types of two connections. They are joined together by facing the ribs inward with a material mineral wool insulation between them. There may be a something insulation part they are going to provide. By using that insulation part, that is easily maintained and it is continuously utilized. Compound panel may be have a semi-fabricated which are glued, attached to the polystyrene insulated slab. Outer panel are joined by means of steel cramps or anything the parts. Then we can say the compound wall panels, the erections are done in two stages. The concrete panels are first fixed to the structure. So usually we need to understand how the connections are most important, because the connections are going to deal whenever they are going to act. So the erections are done in two stages. The concrete panels are first fixed to the structure and the internal part is then erected from inside. So we can say the internal part means insulation and lining part. That particular moment, this is the ribbed type of the section, panel section, or we can say as a solid hollow, and this is a ribbed part. So in this ribbed part, if the prefabricated have the ribs, in the are called ribbed sections, or we can say a ribbed panel section. So rib is the at the central part, we can easily see the thing which is getting us a rib section at here. this is the rib section where we can easily concentrate. Composite prefabricates, the prefabricate with more than one material as called a composite prefabricates. So wherever we are finding one or two materials, we usually we find the prefabrications of more than two materials or one material only. So for that time we can say that the composite prefabrications can be easily maintained. So that is known as a composite prefabrication. Then here we have many materials in different layers, unit joints together to form a single prefabrication, to form a single prefabrication or a sandwich unit. So here each and every individual layer of these prefabricate may take various forms of construction. The composite prefabricates are also classified into three types. So we can say the composite prefabrications, only for the composition of prefabricators we have three classifications. One is solid classification, one is cored section, one is ribbed section. So we can easily know that which is a solid part, which is a cored part, which is a ribbed part. Here the solid section has more than one material with two layers, so that we can say a structural layer or as in a non-structural layer. So structural layer can be utilized as for carrying the loads of structures, and non-structural loads that can be taken as the window panel or door panel. In that way we can easily consider structural layers. So as the structural layers takes the load on the structure and safely resist, withstand the loads, and this is used for the particular type of structures only. And non-structural layers are the insulation finishing layers. So this insulation protects the structure from the thermal radiation or heat, anything in that manner. Cored section, those are the section which have different cores in it and made up of more than one material. So in the composite material there is one more called as a cored section. So that cored section, we can say this as the particular part of cored section. Then ribbed section, ribbed sections, they are prefabricated with the ribs in the particular things basics, and the are structural layers and withstand the load. Here also the non-structural layers or outer finishing layer is used to protect the structure from the heat effect, and they do not carry any kind of a load. They do not carry any kind of load also, which are those which are not carrying any load, those are known as non-structural layers. Here are some more than one material is compared in prefabricate. So this is in the one material forms of a formwork or a framework filled with the another material which is lighter or weaker. Any other type composite prefabricates as one which have a ribbed panels and insulating layers made up of some different materials. Here the ribbed panels take the load and form the structural layers of composite prefabricate. The insulation layer is protective layer. The insulation layer, whatever we are providing as a non-structural, it is a protective layer for the internal material. So now, based on the cross section of efficiency of a material used, based on a single or a more than single material, the member are classified as above. So now the cross section of a precast concrete structure are normally having the following steps. So one is T section, one is I section, one is U or V section. So in the type of sections, in these three type of sections, we can get the particular beams or whatever the connections. The shape may be solid and their profile can be hollow or divided, and windrilled structures. Windrilled structures are those which are having a very less thickness, but the surface area is more, with some provided the openings in between them such that they can be used for more higher raised floors as a door openings, as a window openings, or as a ventilator openings. In that moment part, windrill structures are used. So beams, the beams have a rectangular I section, T section, V section, and a hollow section. So we can easily consider for these type of sections. And once comes the rectangular section, this is the method. Simple cross section of precast structure is sections having to be produced in a small number. The advantage of a simple prefabricated is very single, and disadvantage of a rectangular section is it is not sections are not economical, means the cost is going to increase if we are going with the rectangular sections. If we don't go with rectangular sections and if we go with any other type of sections, so there we can reduce some of the cost, means some of the material which we are providing is usually or commonly it is not used as a structural materials. As we can see, a beams, whichever are columns, whichever are provided, those can be changed in different shapes, such as I shape we can change in shape of the particular other type we can take like that. So design of cross sections, in this part we can say, so now this the design, the other sections I, T, V shaped and hollow cross sections are frequently used in prefabrications. So what is the advantage? So advantage of these sections are for the reaction of a cross sections. So here we have some equations which are called as the forces and the particular part of sections. So we have F is equals to B into H, wherein therefore we consider it as K is equals to B H square by B equal to K. So that part, if we consider in terms of H, so it comes as the H, so that is 6, B H square divided by 6, the particular part, what we take it into the moment of inertia section. So therefore H is equals to square root of K, 6 K divided by B, which we take it as the equation number 2. Now to put second equation in first equation, we get F is equals to B square root of B, means we are putting the value of H into the particular first equation. So F is equals to square root of 6 B square root of particular K, 6 K divided by B. Now when we take the B into multiple of the particular square root inside, so one B gets cancelled and another B of the denominator goes as the cancelled part and numerator will be getting. So 2 times the B is going to come inside, that is F is equals to square root of 6 K B. We are going to get this formula. So using this formula, if we see, hence phi is equals to F divided by P F dash, which is equals to, so F divided by square root of 6 K B. For rectangular cross section, phi is equals to 1, and for the other sections T, I, U and V shape, etc., for this cross sections, phi is less than or equal to 1. So this is the factor wherein we can say the factor which is the efficiency is depending upon the shape also. So phi is the value of efficiency. So efficiency of a rectangular cross section goes up to 1 or more than 1 also. And if we see with the other shape of sections, that the particular efficiencies are less than or equal to 1. The smaller the values of phi, the cross section is more economical. For example, in case of homogeneous beam of I shaped cross section, they are precast reinforced concrete rectangular frame concrete beams of equal loading bearing space. So F is given as 2260 centimeter square and breadth is given as 48 centimeters. So K is equals to 48,500 cubic meters. The depth of equivalent rectangular cross section is H equals to 77 centimeters. So this is one small amount of a numerical which we can see. So from the factor of I section, so that is a factor we can say phi is equals to F divided by square root of 6 kb. So when we substitute the given values into the formula, we can see that the form factor, which is coming as phi equals to 0.605. So therefore we can say that easily it is less than 1, wherein easily less than 1 means we can usually say that this particular part of the value is having good efficiency, means the shape of I section is very, very efficient than the rectangular shape. So the value of phi is equals to 0.605 means that in case of beams made up of timber, steel or any other homogeneous or same material have the same tensile strength. The application of I section is shown in the above figure, means the above which we have taken. Instead of red profile with the same width makes it to save material of 39.5% of material can be easily saved. This concept is called the design of cross section based on the efficiency of material used in prefabrication. So usually this much amount of materials are used in the prefabrication. So let me show this particular part in the clear picture that you can easily understand what is the thing is going to get for you. So this part is the particular efficiency which we can easily see in this sections. And thank you, and see you in the next video.